Great morning, great morning. Welcome once again to Searching the Scriptures. And we on this morning, I got a text from one of the YouTubers about the warfare, and I've been feeling it in my spirit too. And I got up this morning and talking to the Lord before I got up. I've been awake for about an hour, but I lay there talking to him about the warfare and just fighting off my own negative thoughts with you, O God, and the song, Bread of Heaven Sent Down from Glory, many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter, you are the living word. And I begin to think about who we have our hope in. And then I went to the scriptures about hope in 1 John, the third chapter, and he's talk about hope, which if you've ever been pregnant, it's like the expectation, expecting when the time of the delivery will occur. And we know that you can be pregnant with the word because Mary, the mother of Jesus, was pregnant with the word. And we are pregnant with the word too. And so the moment and the hour of the delivery, even though it seems you're hitting heavy, the pains are coming, but the very minute of the birth, you're in expectation, waiting. You know, the water broke. I'm in pains. I'm walking. I'm just carrying this baby. And then once the water break, then you know that the delivery is coming. Even after the water break, some people water break, and the baby is still needs forceps and to go in there and get the head of the baby to get out. So giving birth requires expectation and waiting, because only God knows when that moment is going to happen. So that's what I got hope for. And then we're going to read these scriptures, because we're going to read 1 John and we're going to read Jeremiah 31. And because God is the one that is the breaking of the day, the time when it breaks forth, the Son of Righteousness will arrive with healing in his wings. But we are all pregnant with the word of God. And so we're going to, Frank Hammond's song is the one that says, Bread of Heaven Sent Down from Glory, many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. So I've been looking at that and encouraging, you're looking for deliverance and salvation. And it's like, I know the word of God is true. The time is coming. I thought about the children of Israel for 400 years in bondage. They were in Egypt 430 years. The first 30 years is when Joseph's father and brothers came, and they were down there, and God allowed Joseph to give them the good land. And then when Joseph died, his father died, and then the children of Israel was multiplying down in Egypt, and then they came under bondage. God already prophesied that before they were even born. So God got this. Thank you, Jesus. We just pregnant with the word, and we're like, when are we going to deliver? And some people is walking, and the baby is heavy down, and they say, well, the baby didn't turn, and then they say it's not time yet. I remember my sister, Dale, I hope she doesn't mind, but she was pregnant with my niece, Stacy, and the Lord had told her some things as a sign that she was delivering. He said to her that her husband would not be there to witness, even though he was in the hospital. But I'm going to tell you what happened. I'm going to share it. I hope she doesn't mind. But she said she went to the hospital, and she said this is like her third daughter, but she has four children, one son and three daughters. And this is a miracle child that she was giving birth to. And God already told her what to expect. And they went there, and they first told her, it's not even time yet, and to go back downstairs. And I think she said one of the nurses was saying, like, she was being in drama. It's not even time yet. But the Lord told her, don't go home. Go back. Stay in the hospital, the lobby. She went back, and I went to the lobby and came back upstairs. And then they kept saying, like, she is nowhere near. And she said before the nurse went out, everybody went out, and she was in there, she said, the Lord said, it's time. And that baby popped right on out. And everybody was coming, running, trying to put a band on her, trying to do something because the baby had to deliver. And I believe it's going to be like that with us in time. When Jesus is going to come, that's why I said, no man knoweth the day nor the hour when he shall come. And when God decides this is time, It's going to be like that, like she did with that baby. It's going to be just like that. And then people going to say, it ain't time, it ain't time. And then as soon as it happened, they running, trying to put a ban on her, trying to... That's what it's going to be. We have to, we who are pregnant with the word of God, we're going to know the time and the day. No man know the time nor the day, okay, when the Christ shall appear. And so therefore, that is, we in great expectation. This thing is going to change suddenly. It says suddenly. It's going to change suddenly. Thank you. And God knows what he's doing. So we want to encourage each other. We want to encourage each other. We're pregnant with the word. And we are waiting in expectation. And remember, just like a lot of birth, nobody, I've had three sons. And believe me, the oldest one, I was in labor and labor and labor and labor and labor. They had to go and get a forceps to help him. First of all, sometimes they have to turn them. So a lot of things have to happen in the time of birth, y'all. So we're going to sing this song and we're going to encourage each other, okay? And let's pray. Father, we thank and praise you, first of all, for reminding us, oh God, this is a birth. This is, we are in labor. The whole, with groaning and moaning, oh God, that cannot be uttered. The Holy Spirit is here helping us. We thank and praise you that you are, hallelujah, our living Redeemer. And we thank and praise you for the what you have begun in us, you will perform. Reminding us of what it is to give labor, what it is, the day and the hour, no man knoweth except you, Lord God. But it is truly coming because we are truly pregnant with the word. The word has already been brought forth. And we thank and praise you for the word being established in us, rooting and grounding us, oh God. Help us to have the a confidence and hope, oh God. Hallelujah. Say, believing and hope to the end. We thank and praise you, Lord God, for truly we put our confidence in you, our hope in you. We put our love in you. We thank and praise you that you will bring us through victorious in the mighty name of Jesus. Go as we go into this word, open up our ears to hear and our heart to receive the word. And thank you for my sister and her family and everyone that's on this YouTube channel that are in labor, pregnant with the word of God, that Abba, the hour and in the minute we may not know, Lord God, but we thank and praise you for you have placed your word in us and we shall come forth as pure gold. It's in the mighty master's name of Jesus we pray and count it done. Amen. So this is just, I had something else to teach, but I'm going to do this because this is what's happening right now. It says, bread of life sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter, but you are the living word. Bread of heaven, sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter, you are the living word. Bread of heaven, sent down from glory, hallelujah. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word, you are the living word. Awesome ruler, gentle redeemer, God with us, the living truth. And what a friend we have in you. I'm not saying this right, y'all, but you are the living word. Hallelujah. You are the living. We're going to let you hear Frank Hammond sing it himself. Awesome ruler, gentle redeemer, God with us, hallelujah, the living truth. And what a friend we have in you. You are the living word. And it says, but when we put it all together, this is what we like to call you, Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. You were born on the manger, but on a tree you died to save. Oh, I hate what I'm doing with this, Lord. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. You were born on the manger, but on a tree you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Please forgive me, y'all. Lord Jesus, I thank you. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. You were born on a manger, but on a tree you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. Manger born, but on a tree you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. I'm gonna stop y'all. Thank you for your patience. But I want you to know this one. We call him Jesus, Jesus, manger, born in a manger. But on a tree, he died to save humanity. And we're going to read John, the first chapter. No, 1 John, the third chapter. And it begins, Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore, the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Every man that has this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure. Whosoever committeth sin transgresses also the law, for sin is the transgression of the law. And we know that he was manifested to take away our sins, and in him is no sin. Thank you, Jesus. Whosoever abideth in him sinneth not. Whosoever sinneth has not seen him, neither know him. Little children, let no man deceive you. He that doeth righteousness is righteous, even as he is righteous. He that committeth sin is of the devil, for the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil. And that's what he's doing now, destroying the works of the devil. By God, whosoever is born of God does not commit sin. For his seed, the seed of Christ, remaineth in us. We are pregnant with the word of God, the seed of God. Thank you, Jesus. And he cannot sin, or we cannot sin, because he is born. We have been born of God. Thank you, Jesus. Talking about birth. In this, the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil are manifest in what they do. Whosoever does not righteousness is not of God, neither he that loveth not his brother. So we remain in love. We remain in expectation. We have the seed of God in us. And thank you, Jesus. And his time is coming. Then we go into Jeremiah. Jeremiah 31. At that same time, saith the Lord, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they shall be my people. Thus says the Lord, the people which were left of the sword found grace in the wilderness, even Israel, when I went to cause him to rest. The Lord has appeared of old unto me, saying, Yea, I have loved thee with an everlasting love. Therefore, with loving kindness have I drawn thee. Again, I will build thee, and thou shalt be built, O virgin of Israel. Thank you. Thou shalt again be adorned with tamarinds, and shall go forth in the dance of them that make merry. Thou shalt yet plant vineyards upon the mountains of Samaria, and the planters shall plant and shall eat them as common things. For there shall be a day that the watchmen upon Mount Ephraim shall cry, Arise ye, and let us go up to Mount Zion unto the Lord our God. Thank you, Jesus. For thus says the Lord, Sing with gladness, O Jacob, and shout among the chief of the nations. Publish it. Publish ye, praise you, and say, O Lord, save thy people, the remnant of Israel. Behold, I will bring them from the north, says the Lord, the north country, and gather them from the coast of the earth, and with them, and with them the blind, the lame, the women with child, and her that travails with child together. Thank you, Jesus. With great company shall return thither. Thank you, Jesus. We are pregnant with God. He said, the women, the women with child, the woman with child, her and her that travaileth with child together, great companies shall return thither. They shall come with weeping and with supplication will I lead them, and I will cause them to walk by the rivers of water in a straight way, wherein they shall not stumble. For I am a father, Bakoshe, to Israel. Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O ye nations, and declare it in the isles far off, saying, he that scattered Israel will gather him, Makoshe, and will keep him as a shepherd doth his flock. For the Lord has redeemed Jacob and ransomed him from the hand of him that was stronger than he. Therefore they shall come singing in the heights of Jordan, and shall flow together in the to the goodness of the Lord, for wheat and for wine, and for all, for the young of the flock, and for the head, and their song, soul shall be as a watered garden, and they shall not sorrow any more at all. Then shall the virgin rejoice in the dance, both young men and old men together, for I will turn their mourning into joy, and will comfort them and make them rejoice. Sabakoshe, from their sorrow I will saturate the soul of the priest and with fatness. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the people shall be satisfied with my goodness, says the Lord. Thus says the Lord, a voice. We're going to stop right there. They shall be satisfied with my goodness, says the Lord. So we stopped at verse 14. Jeremiah 1 down. Now, so we have this song, Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you, angel born upon a tree. You came to save humanity. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you, manger born but on a tree. You died to save humanity. You are the living word. Sorry, Frank Hammond. Thank you. But this is in my heart. I can hear him in my heart, y'all. And I pray that you listen to him too. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. Manger born, but on a tree you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, you are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, you are the living word. Angel, manger born, but on a tree you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Please, y'all, I hope I publish it. I want y'all to get the word. Now, this song, I'll let you hear it. And probably I should have just played it, huh? And just said, I don't have no rights to it. Let's play a little bit of it, okay? We're going to play a little bit of it. Okay, they want me to go to someplace else. No, we're not going to do that. We're going to stick with the song, and we're going to upload it, Frank Hammond, okay? And I don't own any rights to this song, but I done messed it up so much, y'all. I need to play it. I need to play it so that y'all can see it. Because he sings it, I mean, beautifully. The Lord has blessed him to sing this song. Hallelujah. And now they want to give me a commercial. Thank you, Jesus. Click to open and to watch. So I want you to know, we are in a state of being pregnant, okay, with the word of God, okay? That's what's going on now. And so, therefore, we have to continue on with the expectation of the day and the hour and the time when it will break forth. The morning will break forth, and I'm not able to upload this song either, y'all. Jesus, look what's happening. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. Manger born, but on a tree, you died to save humanity. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. Manger born, but on a tree, you died to save humanity. You are the living word. You are the living word. Jesus, Jesus. I can't upload it. I'm going to try to get it and upload it. I want to hear this song too. Oh, here we go, y'all. I don't owe any rights. I don't own the rights to this. So I done messed it up, so I got to make y'all play it. The Señor sit down. He's in us. His seed is in us. His seed is in us. We all don't own the right. This is Frank Hammond. You can see he can sing. I'm just making noise. Many things you are, a holy king, God inside. I need to practice this song. Awesome ruler, gentle. I don't own the rights. Living through. We can rejoice. We are pregnant with the word. And it's going to break forth like Jesus. That's what we call. Sing, children, sing. You say, sing. We're going to be singing. Remember, the day nor the hour. No one knows. So this is going to break forth. The seed that's in us, it's going to give way. It's going to give way. The flood waters is coming. That's it. Jesus. That's what we call you. The tree you died to save you now. The tree. Celebrate, sisters, brothers, celebrate. This is God. He's about to break through the water. About to break. Ushering from the throne room of God. The water. I'm going to look at that scripture too. The waters can flow. Okay, we're going to close it up with. I'm going to look up the two scriptures. The water flowing from the throne room of God. And nobody knows the day nor the hour. It's going to break through. Rejoice. It won't be long now. You can feel the heaviness. You can feel the weight. That baby pushing. I want to say to all the mothers whose children are gone before them, they're already clothed in righteousness, and we are going to soon, I believe it. That's what we call you. Jesus. Even dancing with the Lord. My God, my Lord, my Savior, the love of my soul. We're going to stop, y'all. I messed up at the beginning, but I pray you got these scriptures. Jeremiah 31, verse 1 through 14, and 1 John third chapter. And I'm going to give you the other two scriptures. That's right. Okay, we don't own the rights. This is Frank Hammond. And we just thank you for God. Fred, I'm sorry, Frank. It's Fred Hammond. Sorry. I'm messing with the man's name too. Fred Hammond. Okay? All right. We bless saints. Thank you for your patience. Thank you for your patience. Okay. So we thank God for this opportunity from Fred Hammond singing this song. And so I remember his words and I listened to it and I need to go back and listen to it again. And I pray, Lord, that I'm not disrespecting him. Because I really do thank God for the gift to the body of Christ of Fred Hammond. And the hope that he tells us this morning. We have our hope. We got a hope to the end. The Bible said hope to the end. He got a hope to the end. You got to keep this hope to the end because we're pregnant. And we are.
Do this to clear out stuff.
Oh, Lord, there's something else on my phone popping up. Okay, let's close out. Father, we thank and praise you what our hearts have felt and the word has gone forth. And we pray, Lord, please forgive me and my sisters and brothers over the world, forgive me this morning as messing up a little bit. But I pray that the word will go forth and accomplish what you've sent it out to do, that we will understand that we have a hope and a future in the end, that our hope is in Christ. And the time, oh God, is in your hands. Nobody know it except God when it's time to break forth, that the water will break forth and the time will come, that the morning will come, Lord God. And we thank and praise you for the grace and mercy. We thank you for being pregnant with the seed of Christ in us, Lord God, that we shall spring forth and break forth, oh God, hallelujah. In the time when Christ shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. We know that we have this hope in us. And you said that we are purified even as he is pure. We thank and praise you for this song in our hearts. Jesus, Jesus, that's what we call you. A manger born, but on a tree you died to save humanity. And we thank and praise you for the gifts and calling upon our lives as we yield to you our body, soul, and spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. Please don't be mad with me, y'all. Okay, I'm messing up this one. I love you. God loves you. And I want you to be encouraged. I feel him already. Even with the mess up, y'all. I can feel his presence. And so we're going to get ready to go into a prayer for the Mirror Life prayer call. So I'm excited. My sister that texted me, we're praying for you. Everyone that asks for prayer, we are praying. And God knows who we are. And he knows the labor we're going through. He knows the heaviness. You know, and every pregnancy is not always the same. You know, it's some babies are breached. And some babies, giving birth is not. Some people say, my sister, that day God told her, that it's time, and Stacy just pop right out. Now, some people, they labor. My had one aunt was in labor for days. That was in the days in the 50s. The people didn't know about a C-section. She just was, after she had gave birth, she couldn't even walk for a while. That baby had pressed down because it's pressing down. So every birth is not the same, and all of us are pregnant with what God has purposed us in us. And so we're going to bear down. And eventually the water going to break and then things going to break loose and we're going to give way to the Lord. Be encouraged, sisters. I'm just laughing this morning and acting up. And please forgive me my singing. This is off tune, but y'all get to hear Fred Hammond, okay? Please push the like button. Encourage us to come along. It's just to keep lift your day, Lord. We got to hear, listen, we have to encourage ourselves. Look at David. David said, I encourage myself. He encouraged himself. So we got to encourage ourselves, even though we are bearing down and you feel like I'm about to break loose. This thing is too heavy for me. And imagine people who got two and three and four babies inside of their womb. Jesus. Twins. And God only knows what that soul and that body could bear. He only knows what you could bear too. Okay. So please push the like button and continue to follow as God. I have some more stuff that I meant to be talking about. And we're going to go to that. But this morning that just came to, because my spirit was a little heavy. I had to actually encourage myself before I got out of bed, talking to the Lord and talking to my spirit. And like David said, why art thou cast down, O my soul? You need to hope in the Lord. So we got to kind of build ourselves up. No. And sing this song, Jesus, Jesus, from Fred Hammond. Okay. Let's close out. Father, we thank and praise you for what our hearts have felt, and my sisters and brothers all around the world. You know them, Lord God, because nothing is hid from you. We are all open and naked before you. You see your eyes are running to and fro, beholding the good and the evil, and your eyes are always upon your children. And you know what we're going through, and we thank you for reminding us you will put no more on us than we can bear. We thank and praise you, Lord, hallelujah. We are bearing down, and we are hoping to the end. My God, to give birth, oh God, hallelujah, the time and the season. You said all of creation is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God and the children of God. And we thank and praise you that your word, which is in us, the seed of Christ, remained in us. We thank and praise you for this gift that you have given to us as we continue to put our trust and hope in you. It's in Jesus' precious name we pray and we count it done. In Jesus' name, amen. So be blessed. I'm going to listen to this before I upload it, y'all. Oh, God. I'm going to listen to it. If it sounds too bad, I'm not going to upload it. I love you. God loves you. And I got up this morning with heaviness. Now I'm feeling good. Oh, I'm feeling good now. I'm feeling I got hope. I got hope, and I hope you got hope at the end, too. We're going to bear down until we bring this baby. God is going to bring this baby through us. We shall be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. And God going to take care of all the issues that we're concerned about, too. Okay? Be blessed. Walk in victory and lift your head up, okay? Be blessed in Jesus' name.